Hi, this is Freddy TK421 on YouTube, and this video is about me learning how to use a spool gun to weld aluminum. This is my first day ever using it. I didn't read the instructions. I just kind of just tried a bunch of different ways, and this is pretty much a video about a bunch of mistakes, and at the end they get all right. But it's a very windy day today, like super windy out there, so I didn't want to even try it. Okay, so here's me unhooking the normal MIG gun and hooking up the spool gun. It's pretty much easy to figure out. Just plugs in how you would think it plugs in. And if you're not familiar with spool gun, what they are is a little gun with where you put the wire, the aluminum wire, in the gun itself. That way it has less distance to travel and get kinked up, because aluminum is real easy to bend and kink and all that stuff. So you need a spool gun. I don't know if you need one. Yeah, I'm pretty sure you need one. And this is the spool gun right here. I forgot to put a piece in. That's why that spool's coming off. But it's got a real cool little easy way to load it in there and see that it's rolling and feeds the wire out. That's aluminum wire. And it's a really cool gun. And this is the ArcMate 160. Both the gun and this machine are longevity. And you can look them up on the internet, longevity-inc.com. And I'll put a link down below too. But okay, I'm fixing to show you all me welding, and I'm trying to figure this thing out for a long time here and getting frustrated for, I don't know, for too long. And the nozzle was getting stuck as I was welding. And I finally figured out the problem that I was having after I was trying all kinds of different settings and making a bunch of turds like this, that you have to open the cylinder of argon gas, and otherwise it won't work. And I had it all hooked up, I just forgot to open the gas because I went inside to get coffee. And then came back out, and I always have a habit of turning it off. But after I figured out that you need shielding gas, then the well started looking a little better. See, I mean, it's not too good, but it's still getting better than they were. I was getting excited here. I was like, yes, yes, because I was fixing to, you know, I was fixing to go read on the internet how you're supposed to do it. Until I got a little bit of help. So instead of going to read how you're supposed to do it, I just keep messing around. But I'm happy now, because at least they're starting to look a little bit like welds. And here's me just doing some tacking on this aluminum angle iron. The welds get better. This thing, I think, is a good spool gun. I mean, I've never used a spool gun before, but it's working. It's a lot easier than I thought it would be. After I got it figured out. And here's me going uphill, and I kind of melt through, so. And I wasn't even on full power, so that's good that it can be strong enough to melt through. Once I learn my technique, then that'll probably be a good thing. I'm going back over the weld. I don't know if you're supposed to, you're not supposed to do that, but this is just practice. And the rest of the, I just do a few more practice welds, and then, like I said, it's extremely windy here. Like, every once in a while, a big gust will just. And I tried to cover it all, but it was just way too windy. So I'm going to do this again. I'm going to read up a little bit, come back, and, you know, I'm going to do it right next time. Oh, this is just me, like, see, I kind of starting to get it here. But I'm sure I could do a lot better. And I figured out something from getting the tip stuck, that if you use the cleaner from the torch, the acetylene torch, you can just pop that aluminum out no matter how badly you think you melted it in, because it just comes out. So, I guess I can, I'm gonna hook up that spool gun today, finally get a chance. Too bad I can't really weld. Don't leave your hoses out in the sun. It's the second step. I do it, but don't do it yourself. I'm up. They get deteriorated in the sun. So don't do that. And also, don't store your metal outside. But I do that too. And don't leave your shop messy.
like I do. My shop, quote unquote, garage. Oh, dog, look at you, look at you. These don't work, in case you're wondering. It looks cool though. But the grass can't be too tall or else it doesn't work.